line integral. What is line integral? Any integral which is evaluated along a curve is called a line integral. Called line integral. Okay. Now, how to denote line integral? It is simple. From point A to point B, a vector f dot product with vector dr. Okay. R equal to xi plus yj plus zk, dr equal to dxi plus dyj plus dzk. Okay. Then, if my function f is equal to f1i plus f2j plus f3k, then I can write my f dot dr is equal to f1 dx plus f2 dy plus f3 dz. Thus, integral of f dot dr over a curve C is equal to integral of C f1 dx plus f2 dy plus f3 dz. Okay. This is a formula for finding the line integral. Now, example where we have using line integral is finding the work done by a force. Because force is a vector and we are finding a work done over a force when it displaces an object from one point to another point. Next one. Surface integral. We'll see all three different types of integrals, then we'll see the problems related to these. Now, the previous case when integral is evaluated along a curve is called a line integral. Now, in this case, when integral is evaluated over a surface, it's called a surface integral. Just to be evaluated over a surface is called surface integral. Okay, simple definition. The formula for calculating this is surface f dot and ds. Okay. Other way of writing a surface integral is scalar function f and ds, or in terms of a cross product f cross ds. Generally, for calculating surface integral, just write a note. Express given integral to double integral. That means f dot n ds can be represented as f dot n dx dy upon n dot k. That means now the integral which is respect to ds, it is written in terms of dx and dy. So now it is a double integral. Okay. So this helps in solving a problem easily. Okay. This is just one example where we have written dx dy, because the plane is xy plane. If it is some other plane, then definitely this integral, if it is yz plane, then I can write this dy dz n dot I. Okay, this is for yz plane. Okay, third one is volume integral. Now in this, integral is evaluated over a closed surface, over a closed volume. Evaluated over a closed volume. To denote this, I have V f of x comma y comma z dv. I can also write f of x comma y comma z dx dy and dz. Okay, so this is simple. Now with these three integrals, there are certain theorems related which relates volume integral and surface integral and line integral and each other. Okay, we'll see these theorems later. Now we'll see a few problems related to line integral, surface integral and volume integral. Problems. First one. Evaluate f dot dr integral, where f is a function, x square I cap plus y cube j cap. Okay, curve c is given y equal to x square in xy plane from 0 comma 0 to 1 comma. Okay, we have to find this integral. Now see, dr is equal to dx I plus dy j cap. Okay, f dot dr will become x square dx plus y cube dy. Okay, now we can write this integral f dot dr is equal to integral c x square dx plus y cube dy. Substitute y equal to x square, so it will become dy equal to 2x dx. So I can write, let this be equation number 1. So I can write 1 as x square dx plus integral of x square whole to the cube 2x dx. Okay, the limit will be from x equal to 0 to 1 here, x equal to 0 to 1 here. And this will be x cube by 3 plus 2x to the power 8 by 8. This is also from 0 to 1. This is also from 0 to 1. Result will be 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. Equal to 7 by 12. Okay, so in this way this line integral is solved. See, from the beginning we have find f dot dr. This f dot dr is written like this. Okay, on writing again I have to substitute y with x square and then solve the integral in a simple manner and get the answer. Okay, see one more problem. A function f, vector f, is given by yi minus xj. Okay, we have to evaluate f dot dr from 0 comma 0 to 1 comma 1. Now, first case, along the parabola y equal to x square. So if I solve for this, then I can write my integral f dot dr is equal to yi minus xj dot dxi plus dyj. Okay, this will be y dx minus x dy. Okay, so in this, y equal to x square will give me dy equal to 2x dx. Substituting y equal to x square in this given equation, I can write my integral 0 to 1 x square dx minus x 2x dx. So this will be integral 0 to 1 minus x square dx, which is equal to minus 1 by 3, because this integral will give me minus x cube by 3. Substitute 0 to 1, you will get minus 1 by 3. So this is one, when we are finding the integral along the parabola y equal to x square. Now the second case will be along the straight line. From 0 comma 0 to 1 comma 0 and then to 1 comma 1. That means if I write, if I make x coordinates here, then this is my 0 comma 0 point, this is my 1 comma 1 point. Then I have to find the integral first along the curve here and then from here to here. Okay, so this is the, through this curve I have to find my integral. So again, simple, y equal to 0 implies dy equal to 0. That means, and x equal to 1, dx equal to 0. When x varies from 0 to 1. Here also x varies from 0 to 1. Okay. So I can write, let this point be O, this point be A, this point be B. On OA, y equal to 0, dy equal to 0. On AB, x equal to 1, dx equal to 0. So my integral f dot dr will become 0 to 1, 0 dot dx plus zero to one minus one dy. So this gives me result minus one. Okay. Along this curve, x is changing, y is constant. Thus dy equal to zero. Okay. On this curve, x is constant equal to 1. Y is changing. So dx equal to 0, dy will exist other than 0. Okay. So this is a procedure for finding this. Third case is along the line y equal to x. Okay, So it has become very simple. Dy equal to dx. We have to substitute y dx minus x dy. If I substitute from here 0 and 1, I'll get result as 0. Okay. So it depends on the path. Whatever the path we are choosing, my the value of integral will change. Okay. When such things happens, physically these are called non-conservative fields. Okay. Such fields are called non-conservative fields. But if it is independent of the path, that means whatever be the path it is, the value of integral is going to come same. It becomes a conservative field. That is the physical significance of that. Otherwise, mathematically the way we have found the similar procedure we have to follow in exams also. Okay. Now we will solve one problem based on the surface integral. Evaluate f dot and ds where f is given by yzi plus zxj plus xyk and s is part of surface of a sphere x square plus y square plus z square equal to 1 which lies in first octant. Okay. My surface S is like this. This is my X, this is my Y, and this is the region where it is lying. Okay. So, for finding the surface integral, I need to find the N also. N is a unit normal vector. How to find the unit normal vector now? For that, we have to find the gradient of F. Gradient of f, so now gradient of x square plus y square plus z square minus 1, this will be 2x I cap plus 2y j cap plus 2z k cap. Okay. So n is equal to 2x I cap plus 2y k cap plus 2k k cap upon under root of 4x square plus 4y square plus 4z square. This is equal to xi plus yj plus zk upon x square plus y square plus z square under root. But x square plus y square plus z square equal to 1. Equation of sphere. So this has become xi plus yj plus zk. Now we are seeing this procedure is becoming quite complicated, but this is the only way of finding the surface integral. Okay, there is no shortcut method for this. Directly we have to evaluate each step by step and to find it. That's why the probability of such questions coming in gate exams becomes less. But we have to understand the concept, because this concept is similar for all the types of problems. Okay. Now, converting this integral in double integral form, I can write this as dx dy n dot k. Okay. So what is my f dot n? Yz I cap plus zx j cap plus xy k cap dot xi plus yj plus zk. Okay, so this will become 3xyz. N dot k is equal to xi plus yj plus zk dot k is equal to z. Mod of n dot k is equal to z only. So my integral f dot n ds become integral 3xyz upon z dx dy. This is equal to 3 times of integral xy dx dy. Okay. So for solving this integral, I can substitute x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta. Since it is in first octant, my limit and the radius of the sphere is equal to 1. That means radius within the first octant will become equal to 1. Thus, r range will form 0 to 1. Theta range will be from 0 to pi by 2. First octant. Okay. So this integral I can write it as 0 to pi by 2. 0 to 1. This is related to r. This is related to theta. R cos theta. R sin theta. R d theta dr. Okay, so right, changing to polar coordinates. Okay, now solving this integral 0 to pi by 2 r to the power 4 by 4 0 to 1 cos theta sin theta d theta. This gives me result 3 by 8. So the answer is 3 by 8. So we have seen such a long process for solving such a surface integral. Okay. So that's why these questions are least expected in gate exam. But the general principle of finding the surface integral we should know. Okay. So I think this clears the concept of finding the surface integral. Now one more problem for finding the volume integral. Okay. Evaluate this dv, where v is a closed region bounded by z equal to 4 minus x square and the planes x equal to 0, y equal to 0, y equal to 2 and z equal to 0. Okay. Solution. Before starting, you should find the limits of x, y and z. Okay. So how to find those limits? See, z anyway is varying from 0 to 4 minus x square. Okay. The cylinder z equal to 4 minus x square meets x axis, y equal to 0, z equal to 0 at x square equal to 4 or x equal to 2 point on the positive side. That means 2 comma 0 comma 0 point. Same cylinder meets z axis z-axis means x equal to 0 and y equal to 0 at point z equal to 4. So this point will become 0 comma 0 comma 4. Thus x ranges from 0 to 2, y ranges again from 0 to 2, z ranges from 0 to 4 minus x square. Now I can write integral 2x plus y dv. There is no dot product, there is no cross product, nothing. It is a simple integral. This will be 0 to 2, 0 to 2, x square, 2x plus y, dx, dy, and dz. Now, we just need to solve the integral, okay? So, first we can solve with respect to z. X plus y z 0 to 4 minus x square dx dy. Okay, then we can write this as x plus y 4 minus x square dx dy. Okay, now again I can integrate with respect to y. 4 minus x square outside, 2xy plus y square by 2 from 0 to 2. This will give me x equal to 0 to 2, 4 minus x square, 4x plus 2 dx. Finally, this integral can be solved. Opening the bracket, 4 plus 8x minus x square minus 2x cube. Okay. Outside, x equal to 0 to 2 dx. Solving this integral gives me the answer 80 by 3. You can solve, you can try this integral and can solve this. Okay. So this is a procedure for solving the volume integral. Now when we will see the theorem, we will understand how to convert the volume integral into a surface integral. Okay. Or surface integral to line integral, or to any of these three interconversions. Okay.